opening statement. It was a very disappointing showing by us. I was very disappointed in a lot of phases of the game. We had a game plan going in that I thought when we did play it, we did a really nice job. And for whatever reason, got away from the game plan that we had. And when we did, Arkansas did a great job of taking advantage of that. So they're a really good team. One of the things that we had to do was take care of the ball on our side of the net. That was part of the game plan. And as you can see with the number of errors we had, we didn't do that. Missed too many serves, had too many hitting errors. They had 16 blocks, and I'll bet half of those blocks were on balls and we're just tipping to, you know, get them out of system, you know, not going for kills, just really kind of getting them out of system so we could play for the next ball. And we just couldn't get the ball to where we needed to. And so that was disappointing.
What else do you see?
I mean, the hitting errors is the thing that jumps out. I mean, that's a huge, huge, huge number. You know, 30 hitting errors is absolutely ridiculous. You know, we always have enough kills. We've had more kills in every single match we've played this year against whoever we played. And that scores the most points. Kill skills the most points. So we always are scoring enough points on kills, always. And we're just making some bad unforced errors. I mean, there's some unforced errors that, okay, you know, you went for it, we missed it by a foot, or you made a great swing and they might have made a great play on it, you know, with a block, a great blocking move, those type of things. But the thing that's disappointing is that we just didn't take care of it. Some of the errors didn't come on this, or a lot of the errors didn't. A lot of the errors came on balls that we shouldn't have made errors on, and that's what the disappointment is.
Do you get as many blocks as you'd like? I know Kowalski's not out there.
Well, you know, again, that's part of our, you know, not following our plan. You know, we had a game plan on it, and we, you know, for whatever reason, you know, maybe they were seeing something, you know, our players were seeing something different than, you know, what we wanted them to do, and then, you know, because they have some freedom out there, you know, they do have some freedom to you know, change some things up, but, you know, I kept trying to remind them of getting back to the game plan on where we wanted to set up the block on different players, and we just didn't do that. You know, we would adjust to their middle and be in front of them and do a great job of fronting them, but then we wouldn't jump when they got set. You know, we were late on it. And I Stephanie Shalen was a little, hasn't played a lot yet, so, you know, I can understand a little bit, but, you know, she played last year and she's been practicing. So, you know, just things that were happening that I didn't really understand why they were happening. So, you know, we'll just have to get back in the gym and work on those things, you know.
Midway through the third, it looked like you took Kelsey out, and then in the fourth, it looked like Didi was also out. Are you trying to send a message with
I'm always going to play to win. You know, the last thing you're going to do is send a message in the middle of a match. You know, and they're good kids. You know, I mean, you know, you want to send a message, you know, to a kid that isn't good. You know, they're good kids, and you know, they're not trying to do things on purpose. I don't think they just weren't doing the things that we needed them to do. They're breaking down some, you know, technically a little bit here and there. Kelsey is, you know, working her tail off. She's carried us. You know, the last thing I'm going to do is try and send a message where she just wasn't, you know, playing well right then. You know, she's had a bunch of errors. She wasn't getting kills. The other team had a real good, you know, block on her. I thought if I put Kayla in, because Kayla's, you know, she's an all-region player, all-American. You know, it's not like I'm putting somebody in that can't play, you know. So I put Kayla in to see if we can get a spark in that situation. And then Didi, she's coming back from her ankle. But, you know, she's, again, just technically wasn't doing some of the things that would help her be more effective. And just probably, you know, being out of practice for, you know, 3 weeks or 2 weeks has affected that. So, you know, those are the reasons I took them out, because they weren't effective with the things that we needed them to be effective with. And there are, you know, reasons for them. You know, like I said, you know, Kelsey gets to have a bad game. You know, I mean, she does. And so she had a bad game. In her bad game, she's still leading us in kills and digs. You know, so, you know, it's not to send a message, because we're playing to win every match, and she does too many good things and always has for our program. It was just, hey, you know, might need to try and make a change, get a little spark in there. Kayla's a good spark for us, good player. You know, give her a rest and then have her come back maybe a little bit fresher then for that next set. So that's really what the thought process
is. Doing something different defensively to kind of shake us off of our...
No, it's really on our side. Like, we do scout the other teams and practice for them, but it's about us, and those missed serves are on us, and those defensive plays are on us.
Is there something different that's been going on lately that's been causing these errors?
No, we we're not ourselves right now, and we need to pull together as a team, and it's everything on our side. It's nothing that any other team is doing to us, because we should have just beat them in three outright if we were playing the way that we need to play.
Personally, 2,000 career assists, seventh Lady Vol to do that. Just talk a little bit about what that mark means to you.
It means a lot. I have great hitters around me, and the passes are great, so we have every option, and it's fun to set these girls because they do get so many kills, and it's a fun team to play with.
Ask Rob this, you know, with the way the Missouri match ended and then tonight, is there just something funky going on that's just not right now?
I mean, yeah, the team doesn't feel right. Like, it doesn't feel, we didn't lose any of our main players from last year, and that's very frustrating because it's the same girls out there on the court, so we need to figure out what's going on wrong and fix it if we want to get to where we need to be.
So, thank you.
Yeah. How do you fix something like that? Is it a chemistry issue?
I mean, yeah, and it's everybody, I mean, you can't make somebody else do something, so if you take care of yourself, then everybody, it will build on the team because it is every person needs to do something different right now.
Is it something that kind of like gets in your head, like we're not playing well, and then you start overthinking?
I mean, I don't think we overthink because we know that everyone's behind each other, but we need to, it's little things, like even if you miss one play, you know your teammate's there for you, so it's frustrating because we do have that, so something else that we need to figure out.